up this cave for tours, they would give you a candle. They would light this candle, hand it to you, and say, go have fun. Oh, but, and you have to be told this, when that candle gets burned down halfway, you folks need to turn around. Now think about it. Why would you have to be told that? You're going to be, you know why. Tell me why.
Because if it took half a candle to get there, it's going to take half a candle.
Exactly, but you're going to be so busy trying to see stuff, you're going to forget all about where you're doing and where you're at, right? Mm-hmm. Now when that candle gets wet, and the light goes out, what are you going to do? It's wet and it won't relight. These candles are pretty rough. They really work. Well, I'm going to turn the lights off, show you total darkness now. Two places you can find natural total darkness. That's in a cave, like we are today. The other place is in the bottom of the ocean. We're not going to the ocean today.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. Here's first of all darkness. I want you folks to take your phones, put them down against your leg. Everybody hear me? Okay, put them down, darken them. You don't turn them off, just put them down so nobody sees the light on. Okay? Here's total darkness now. And I'm going to show you candlelight. Now, if you get scared, now this is important, just close your eyes. Okay? Here we go. Everybody got your kid in their arms?
Yep.
Here we go. Now, put your hand in front of your face. Can you see anything?
No.
Oh, I heard that. Total darkness. Okay, here's candlelight. We'll get to the light here real quick. Here's candlelight.
Oh,
can you imagine
spooky.
Walking through a cave with this?
No.
What do you see?
Nothing. Right. Scariness.
What happens if somebody taps you and you don't know who it is?
No. Oh, no.
Would that not scare you if somebody taps you in a cave?
Yes.
Well, we did something. We heard about these wonderful new inventions from Mr. Thomas Edison called the light bulb. We had to have it. We took a steam engine, we hooked it to a generator, ran wires in our cave, went out and got all of his new light bulbs. Not all of them, but we got our share. Here's what it looked like. In the late 1800s, now we're talking about the walking in the tours in the 1800s. This is 1889. We came in here and put this wonderful new invention in here. People got word about it. Look around. You can see this cave now, can't you?
Yeah.
It's better than having a candle, right? Yeah. If you like brown.
State of the art. State of the art.
Yeah. At the time it was.
Yeah, at the time.
People heard about how you can see this cave now without a candle. They come running out. They wanted to come in here. I mean, they camped out, lined up for days to come in here and see this wonderful looking new light bulb. Didn't give a hoot about this cave. That was pretty important stuff back there. Took away all that hassle filling lanterns at night, lighting them and putting them out, relighting them. It's a pretty important thing at the time. Well, 1970, a man came in here and says, you guys are doing it wrong. Get the lights off the ceiling. That's called direct lighting. Put it on the ground, shine up on the stuff. That's called indirect, obviously. Cover the lights up so you can't see the bulbs. Hide the wires. Nobody wants to see wires. He said, give it color, and you'll see what happens. He said, we're doing it in movies. Everybody, here's what he's talking about. Look right back here at those two pillars. They're brown, right? Look what happens when you put the light to them. They're white. It changes. But look around now, the difference you've seen from that last light. So much shapes, colors, and shadows, right? Isn't it beautiful?
Yes.
It's made a big difference. I hope they paid him well for this, because he did a wonderful job. And that's the way it is today, since 1970.
Wow.
Okay. Now, you folks heard of sea codes. Yeah, 1970 is when we changed over these lights here. Okay. Sea codes is when the ground just drops down. Leaves a big hole in the ground. We have two in our cave. We have two bridges going over two sea coasts. We're going to stop on the second one. We're going to see our river that I told you about earlier and show you where our cave animals live, okay? All right. Here we go. You got a question, man?
I need some of that on my teeth. Yeah, just grow some. 100 years, I would grow some.
Ching.